Afternoon, everyone, and thank you for joining today's update. As of today, we have had 879,825 COVID-19 cases, 2,061 new cases reported since yesterday, 1,039 people in the hospital, and sadly, 11,622 people who've died. Our prayers continue to be with those who've lost loved ones or who are fighting this virus. As we discussed at Tuesday's briefing, North Carolina continues to focus on getting vaccines into arms as quickly and as fairly as possible. And I'm so grateful for our providers out there who continue to meet that challenge. With the addition of a third safe and effective one-shot vaccine and a steady increase in both two-shot vaccines, we were able to open all of Group 3 for vaccinations on March the 3rd. And that meant that all of our frontline essential workers could be in line to get shots. This week, Department of Health and Human Services officials have continued to survey providers about how they're handling the demand from Group 1 and 3 and whether they have the capacity to move forward. Today, based on their feedback and the expected vaccine supply over the next several days, we're announcing that some members of Group 4 will be able to be eligible to receive their vaccine beginning March the 17th, a week earlier than we anticipated. Group 4 will be open to people with medical conditions that put them at higher risk for severe COVID-19 illness. Also eligible starting March 17th will be people living in some congregate settings that increase their risk of exposure. The additional members of Group 4 will be eligible for vaccines beginning April the 7th. As with previous statewide group eligibility changes, some providers in some parts of the state may not be ready to move into Group 4 on March the 17th. And we want them to make sure that they're still meeting the demand in Groups 1 through 3. This move to Group 4 is good news, and it's possible because of the tireless work of our state health officials, vaccine providers, federal partners, our North Carolina National Guard and emergency management, and so many others. And I want you to know that your work is making all the difference. Yesterday, I toured the FEMA-supported site in Greensboro, and it's really going well. I talked to a lot of people who had just gotten their shots. More than 3,300 shots were given on the first day there. And I know that there are many other efforts across the state getting vaccines to people as quickly and as fairly as possible. So far, about 11% of North Carolinians are fully vaccinated, and about 18% have had their first shots. 66% of the people 65 and older, our most vulnerable